Hello, and welcome to our short video on how to design a photodiode amplifier circuit. This schematic represents a photodiode amplifier circuit. Photodiode amplifier circuits are used to convert and amplify the light-dependent input current from a photodiode to an output voltage. The current-to-voltage gain of the photodiode amplifier circuit is set by the feedback resistor, R1. A reference voltage, Vref, is used to bias up the output voltage to prevent the output from saturating to the negative supply with a 0-amp input current. This video explains how to design the circuit using TI's OPA322 in a few easy steps. This circuit inputs a current from 0 to 2.4 microamps and outputs a voltage from 100 millivolts to 4.9 volts. It utilizes a single 5-volt supply, reference voltage of 100 millivolts, and has a bandwidth of 20 kHz. The equation for VO is the transfer function of the circuit. The first term, I times R1, is the input current to the output voltage conversion. The second term, VCC times R3 divided by R2 plus R3, is the reference voltage used to bias up the output. The first step is to calculate the value of the feedback resistor, R1. We calculate this by dividing the output voltage swing, VO max minus VO min, by the maximum input current, I max. R1 is calculated to be 2 megaohms. The next step is to calculate the feedback capacitor, C1, to meet the circuit bandwidth goal. C1 is calculated to be 3.97 picofarads, with the equation given on the slide. The next closest standard capacitor value is 3.3 picofarads, so we will use this value for the design as shown by C1 in the schematic. Now we need to determine the necessary op-amp gain bandwidth for the circuit to be stable. The minimum op-amp gain bandwidth product is calculated using this inequality. Ci is the sum of the photodiode junction capacitance, Cj, the differential input capacitance of the op-amp, CD, and the common mode input capacitance of the op-amp, CCM. Using these equations, we calculate that the gain bandwidth of the op-amp must be greater than 170 kHz to ensure the amplifier is stable. The gain bandwidth of the OPA322 is 20 MHz, so this requirement is met. The next step is to calculate the voltage divider resistors that provide a 100 millivolt reference voltage given a supply of 5 volts. Rearranging a standard voltage divider equation shows us that R2 must be 49 times larger than R3. By selecting R3 as 280 ohms, we calculate R2 as 13.7 kiloohms. The last step is to calculate the cutoff frequency, FC, due to C2, which helps filter noise out of the reference voltage. Here we will select C2 as 1 microfarad. Using the equation shown, we calculate the cutoff frequency to be 580 Hz. A DC sweep of the input current from 0 amps to 2.4 microamps yields an output voltage from 100 millivolts to 4.9 volts. This verifies the functionality of the circuit. Running an AC sweep analysis, we find that the bandwidth of the circuit is 24.1 kHz. Which meets our design goal of 20 kHz. When designing a photodiode amplifier circuit, there are a few design notes to be aware of. First, be sure to use a bias voltage, Vref, to prevent the output from saturating to the negative power supply rail when the input current is 0 amps. Next, be sure to use a JFET or CMOS input op-amp with low input bias current to reduce DC errors. Finally, set the output range based on the linear output swing of the amplifier. Texas Instruments has many online resources to help you design circuits with op-amps. This includes reference designs and guides, educational videos, simulation and prototyping tools, support resources, and search tools. Thank you for taking the time to watch this short presentation on how to design a photodiode amplifier circuit. Please visit www.ti.com for additional information and resources.